Hello, soul loves. It's Kimberly with Celestial Juju, and we got another retrograde happening, on June 17th for 139 days. Saturn will be tipping his hat to you, so you better be holding on to your hat, because Saturn is the Lord of karma, structures, and authority, and all of those things. And Saturn has been in Pisces, and Saturn is getting ready to go retrograde. Yes, it is. So when Saturn goes retrograde, what does it do? How does it shake up your world? So I'm telling you, hold on to your hats, because it's going to be time to be it. Dumping your emotional baggage. It's making a cosmic U-turn in the dreamy waters of Pisces. This slow-moving planet is notorious for dishing out karma and demanding discipline. And what happens when it decides to boogie in reverse with our earthly perspectives? Buckle up, because you're going to go into, it could be a topsy-turvy, emotional dumping time. Okay, so picture this. Saturn with its stern face and its rule book in its hand, it's waltzing into the whimsical Pisces world, okay? It's been there. It's already walked in. And now it's going to turn itself around. It's like, put your left, what is that? Put your right foot in, put your left foot in, turn yourself around. That's what Saturn's doing, okay, in this world of Pisces. So it's like this strict school teacher stumbling into the colorful circus. And Neptune, the planet of dreams, holds the reins of Pisces, urging us to take flight into alternative realities. But fear not, dear readers, dear listeners, you all are listeners. Because Saturn is here to slap some structure into those fantasy dreams. Yeah. So in this retrograde period, Pisces is known for its spiritual inclinations, and it will embark on a journey in the inner growth like never before. Saturn's backward motion, and this sign means it's time to roll up your sleeves and get serious about your spiritual evolution. Expect ambitions to soar new heights as we strive to align our inner and outer worlds. So here we go, people. We're going to hold on to this energy, because what seemed to be structured could have some a new chemistry to it, a whole new alchemy, because any energy of unchartered emotional baggage could come up into your equation. So it's time to pack. It's time to pack a lot. It's time to pack your lot and ditch what no longer serves you in our tangible progress. Brace yourselves, because this retrograde will send emotions into a frenzy. Confusion could rain up. We could be forced to take a pragmatic look at our lives. But fear not, because unlike the Mars in retrograde, Saturn's going to take its time, and it's going to ensure you that you de-establish the effects, destabilizing, like it's going to reestablish as it destabilizes the energies, so that you'll come out like you have been in this meteorite share of enlightenment. because the structures around you could fall. Okay. Okay. So don't be afraid to shake up things a little. And know that if things are being shaken up in your 3D world, that it's this cosmic dance and it's time to give these pre-established patterns a makeover. So the dice is rolling whether you want it to or not, because the end result could be so rewarding. And Saturn, it always has a trick up its celestial sleeve to ensure our growth and evolution. So as it waltzes through this retrograde, let go of your fear, embrace the unknown, rewrite the rules for your own cosmic journey. This is a chance to refine the clock, refine the patterns, refine relationships with authority, boundaries, and commitments. It's time for introspective reflection, and most importantly, a whole lot of self-love and growth. So grab your telescopes, stargazers, because this energy is going to take us on a ride through the cosmos. And remember, as we navigate this celestial dance, Saturn's got your backs because it's making sure in your newfound wisdom that the evolution will be worth every moment of every turn. Okay? So the energy, the five things that you need to know about the energies are: it's time for this introspective reflection, reassessment. And when Saturn, associated with authority and responsibility and stability, goes retrograde, it brings unique set of influence to the collective. So the sensitive Pisces energy in the compassionate sign and the retrograde motion of the Saturn can invoke profound internal shift, and in a way that we can relate to authority, boundaries, and commitments. And here's your key themes: reclaiming personal authority. Saturn in retrograde invites us to reevaluate our relationships with authority figures, systems, and structures. It's time to question external sources of authority. Yep. Instead of focusing on cultivating our inner wisdom and our personal sovereignty, we may find ourselves reclaiming our power and challenging the societal norms. So this is for the collective people, okay? So that could be what's happening. Or the expectations no longer align to our authentic self. It's like wake up time, because this energy is going into the collective. Okay, second thing to know in the collective, it's reconsidering boundaries. Saturn governs boundaries, and in this retrograde motion may inspire us to re-examine, redefine our personal boundaries. This can involve reflecting on where we've been too rigid or too lenient, and finding a healthy balance that respects both our needs and our needs of others. An opportunity to create more compassion and empathic boundaries, okay? And allow us for emotional growth and connections. Number three, reviewing commitments. During this Saturn retrograde, commitments, responsibilities come under scrutiny. It's time to reassess the commitments that you've made and determine whether they align to our long-term goals and values. We may need to let go of obligations that no longer serve us or it not the terms, renegotiate, if it no longer ignites you, then renegotiate. I can't say that now. Okay. Think about it again. The terms to ensure you to remain in alignment with your own evolving path. Number four thing to know, reflecting on achievements and mastery. Saturn is associated with achievement, with mastery, and its retrograde phase prompts us to reflect on our past accomplishments, and it's an opportunity to celebrate our growth, acknowledgement, and our successes, and identify the areas where we have room to improve. It's time to refine our skills and deepen our knowledge and invest in some self-mastery. So it's a great time to invest in yourself with whatever that is, like whatever that mastery is that you're wanting to bring in right now. Okay. Or maybe you didn't know you wanted to bring it in. So number five thing to know is, for the collective, is embracing interperspective. I cannot talk today. In spiritual growth, Pisces is this deep inward planet in a spiritual sign. And so when Saturn goes retrograde here, it intensifies the spiritual energies. So this period encourages us to explore in practices that nurture our spiritual well-being. And it's ideal time for meditation, for dream analysis, and any activities that help us gain insight into our deeper selves. So it'd be a really good time to do a dream journal and see what your subconscious is telling you, because it's, you know, our mind is always going, and it's going during our sleep time, and you might as well use your tracking of your subconscious, because you can ask it before you go to sleep to give you messages. And whether or not you are conscious with it, it's going to happen. And so then you can be more aware of that. Okay, so we're going to go into all signs. So just know that, you know, astrology is a tool to help you bring in your self-awareness and your guidance, and that each transit has its own unique energy and its influence that's going to be in different areas of your life. And that's what doing this is. I'm a Western astrologer using the whole sign system for this energy analysis and report for you. So look at your rising sign, which is who you are internally. It's your inner self. Your sun is your personality that you show to the world, and your moon is your emotional side. And the sun also represents father in your chart, and the moon is mother in your chart, where your rising is you. Okay. So listen up to all of those, because it's your own unique energy combination that brings these influences into your life. And this are just clues to the maps that you left behind for yourself. Okay. So as Saturn continues through this journey, it's going to bring up this unique energy influence for each of the signs. So let's embrace these opportunities of wisdom and self-reflection. And remember, the Pacific empath will be in your chart of how it affects you. So here we go. Aries, I started to say rising. Okay, Aries rising. It's in your 12th house. With Saturn transiting in your 12th house, it's going to bring up a period of going within, spiritual growth, and solitude. This transit encourages you to release old patterns, heal past wounds, and engage in self-reflection. You may find yourself drawn to spiritual practices, therapy, retreats. It's a perfect time for all of those for you. It's essential to establish healthy boundaries and practice self-care to navigate this transit with grace and wisdom. Loose ends from your past could come back to haunt you. You may need to face your fears, deal with the emotions you were holding on to, and in addition, a past partner could also come back into your life. You may need to be certain if you're ready to give them a chance or not. While Saturn is retrograde, you may feel why it's retrograde in Pisces. You may feel the need to be willing to compromise energy with your family, with your children, your loved ones, and to keep harmony in your relationships. Taurus, 11th house, Pisces is going to be in your, it's going to be in your 11th house with Saturn transiting the 11th house. It brings a focus on friendships, social networks, long-term goals. This transit encourages you to evaluate your associates, align yourself with people who share your values and ambitions. It's time to reassess your role within group dynamics and take leadership responsibilities. Embrace the discipline needed to build the solid network of supportive connection. Your friendships will be put to the test during this retrograde period. In addition, you are highly receptive during this time to other people's energies. Make sure, which makes you more vulnerable, okay? And exposes you to negative influences. So it's time to cut out any toxic relationships out of your life, dear Taurus, and allow yourself to grow by being surrounded by people that truly value and respect you. Okay, Gemini, 10th house. This Saturn transit through your 10th house highlights your career, public image, and ambitions. The period calls for more serious, structured approach to your professional life, and you may experience a shift in responsibilities or face increased pressure to meet your long-term goals. Embrace the discipline and the dedication necessary to advance your chosen field and establish a reputation built on integrity and hard work. This is not the time for you to make rushed decisions regarding your career, your reputation, or professional life. Saturn moving backwards through Pisces is going to increase the hustle, and you must be patient. Remember, good things take time. Use the energy to reflect on your goals and ensure you're to follow your heart's desire. Okay, Cancer. Cancer rising, it's in your 9th house. With Saturn in the 9th house, your focus turns more towards higher education, spirituality, and long-term travel. This transit encourages you to deepen your knowledge and pursue intellectual growth, embrace the structure and approach to your belief systems. It may be time to seek wisdom from mentors, to engage in formal education, to embrace discipline needed to expand your horizons and find meaning in your spiritual pursuits. Saturn retrograding in Pisces might make you feel like time stands still and you're not making any progress. But as a result, you will question your values and your beliefs. This ride can be a bit uncomfortable, but the growth comes from when you leave your comfort zone. Cancer, when you leave your comfort zone, instead of trying to stay inside that shell and make it all comfortable, it's going to expand when you leave your comfort zone. Okay, Leo, 8th house. Leo rising, this will be in your 8th house. Saturn retrograding through the eighth house signifies a period of transformation, shared resources, and intimacy. That's your other people money house. This transit prompts you to take a serious and responsible approach to your joint finances, investments, and emotional connections. It may be time to review and consolidate debt, and engage in the deeper emotional healing. Embrace the discipline required to establish healthy boundaries and strengthen your intimate relationships. Saturn in retrograde in Pisces sets you on a soul-searching adventure, and your dreams are now cosmic portal and important messages to you. So make sure to listen. You could be feeling more nostalgic and spend more time reflecting on your past. However, this is behind you, and what is behind you, you can't change. But instead, Saturn wants you, only you can only change your view of it and how it has a grip on you. Okay, instead, Saturn wants you to make the most important lessons and use them. Virgo, it's in your seventh house. Pisces is in your seventh house. Virgo rising is in your seventh house. With Saturn in the seventh house, your focus shifts to partnerships, your personal and professional partnerships. This transit encourages you to reassess your commitments and establish solid foundations in your relationships. It's time to take responsibility for your role within partnerships and work towards greater stability and longevity. Embrace the discipline needed to cultivate healthy and balanced connection with others. During this Saturn retrograde in Pisces, relationships that will stand the test of time under this transit will prove to be the ones you need to keep in your life. The retrograde may not seem like it's on your side, but it is. You may experience difficulties and challenges in your intimate relationships because you need to open your eyes and know that you are with the right person. If not, this transit is setting you up to be free so that you can search for your true soulmates, whatever those are, in whatever way, in whatever partnerships. Okay. Hi, moving on to Libra, talking about the queen of relationships. Okay, Libra, this Pisces energy is going to be in your sixth house. Saturn is going to transit through the sixth house of highlights, health, daily routines, work, environments. This period calls for discipline, structured approach to your physical well-being and your work life. You may experience an increased responsibility in the need to establish better routines and habits. Embrace the discipline required to maintain healthy work-life balance and enhance your overall productivity and well-being. Your desire to help and to be of service to others is increased during this retrograde time period. You may feel generous and kind and ready to fight against the injustice of the world. Under this transit, your futuristic ideas, your thinking, your vision, could change the world. The visions could come to you on actually how to change the world, Libra. Okay, it will come to surface. Remember, the universe always rewards good deeds. Okay, Scorpio rising, fifth house. Saturn's transit is going to go through the fifth house of Pisces, which brings profound impact and self-expression, creativity, and romance. It may encourage a more serious and disciplined approach to your artistic endeavors, urging you to refine your skills and commit to your passions.
This period can bring a sense of responsibility and maturity to your romantic relationships, prompting you to seek stability and a long-term commitment. During this retrograde period, Saturn going backwards in Pisces, creative blockages and stagnation in your mental activities are more likely to be a part of your daily life, your daily routine. So breathe when it happens. Okay. Change what you're doing. Get away from it. Surrender to something. As a result, it may be more challenging for you to think outside of the box, which usually comes naturally to you. So you could get frustrated with this, Scorpio. Okay, so Saturn's lessons is to stay patient with the transit and the trust the process. In times you will feel frustrated, take a walk in nature and allow your mind to unwind. Do something different for yourself, some kind of movement, some kind of free-flowing thing, maybe coloring. Just let the colors flow to reset the points in your mind, because that is letting go of things for you. That's what's happening. When you get stagnated and frustrated, you're at like a stale place and it wants to expand past that, dear Scorpio. Okay. Sagittarius, it's in your fourth house. With this Saturn transiting the fourth house, your focus turns towards your home, family, and emotional foundation. The transit may highlight the need for stability and structure within your domestic sphere. It could be a time for renovations, for establishing. That just stopped for some reason. I hope it's still recording. establishing stronger boundaries with family and members, or taking on more responsibility related to your household. Take a balanced approach to nurture your emotional well-being while ensuring a solid foundation for future growth. Because this energy in your family, your loved ones will rely on your support and protection. They will rely on that during this time period. Okay. They may lean on you a little bit. With Saturn retrograding in Pisces, your domestic areas may not be the most harmonious during this time period. So the aspect of your life, in that aspect of your life right now, use your incredible ability to read people's energies and to help you find out how your loved ones really feel. Allow your instincts to lead the way. Sagittarius. Okay, Capricorn. Saturn's transit through the third house is the emphasis on communication, learning, relationships with siblings and neighbors. This period may inspire you to take your intellectual pursuits more serious, fostering discipline, study, and acquiring new skills. It could also bring up a sense of responsibility and maturity to your interactions and engagements within your local community. Use this time to refine your communication style. Take on responsibilities that enhance your mental development, okay? During this retrograde, you may feel more like the more you try, the further you get away from your goals and ambitions. So what's happening is Saturn in Pisces is trying to teach you communication. Your connection to neighbors and siblings and cousins could be more challenging, but it's more important to acknowledge that these are things that money can't buy, and that the things like happiness, love, and health. And with you being, you know, Saturn is your, Capricorn. So you may really feel the difference in the energy and going into this inner reflection of what is life really about, and what is the old structure leaving and what's coming in for you during this expanded time period. Okay, Aquarius, it's your ancient ruler. Okay, Aquarius, second house Aquarius rising with this Saturn transversing your second house, your focus shifts towards your finances. This is your money house, your finances, your values, your self-worth. This transit encourages you to assess your financial responsibilities and develop more disciplined, strategic approach to money matters. It's time to reevaluate your values, prioritize your financial stability, and potentially make long-term investments. Cultivate a sense of self-worth that aligns you to your true values and material aspirations. This retrograde in Pisces inspires you to make profound analysis and to set yourself free from what's been holding you back, Aquarius. Okay? Your inner transition is now under the microscope. And you will ensure that you are on the track, on track with your life. Okay. This transit is time for you to be in preparation, regrouping, and deciding where your next move is. You know, you've had a lot of that for this year. A lot of that's been going on for you. Okay. So this is going to be time for you to hone it in. Okay. Pisces, it's in your first house, Pisces. It's all about your first house. This Saturn retrogrades through your first house. It signifies a period of inner reflection and personal growth. You may feel a sense of responsibility to redefine your identity and appearance and your overall self-image. Embrace the discipline. Take charge of your personal goals and ambitions. The transit calls for a more mature, structured approach to self-care, allowing you to solidify your individuality and lay groundwork for future success. During this retrograde time period, self-organization is the main key to minimizing the responsibilities and the possible negative effect of the Saturn retrograde. Luckily, this is an area where you shine the most. However, things tend not to go your way, so it can be frustrating during this karmic time for you. Patience is the virtue, Pisces. Patience is the virtue. Okay? Do not force things to happen and go with the flow and trust your instincts. Okay, that's it. That's our thing. The last time that Saturn was retrograde in Pisces was, it was in Pisces during May 1993 to April 1996. And so that's when the retrograde was. So what was happening during your life during those time periods, because it's going to be similar energy that it was then. So you might want to do a trip down memory lane to see what karmic stuff that you've got rid of since then. So thank you all. Thank you all so much. Thank you for incarnating, being here in this time we call now on this planet that you came in to resolve your karma from all of your timelines, your lifetimes, from your soul, from your DNA, and that you're here to do this and to know that we're in this exciting time period that the Lord of Karma is going retrograde in the planet ruled by Neptune. That's all of this transit energy, and that we have this time to do this, to use this energy of the practical Saturn, applying the energy to all expansion. And what can you download and bring back during this time period? So it's Kimberly with Celestial Juju. Thank you so much. Thank you. So like, subscribe, do all of those things. I am still in my practical work off putting these gardens in. Oh, this morning I did two more squash and oregano. And so now I'm like moving out into self-sustainability. So if you want your name to be put in my transformational garden, just leave a comment and say, yes, I would like to be a part of this. Leave a comment on my YouTube and you will be put in the transformation garden. Okay. Be blessed and enjoy these retrogrades that we have all around us in this time. We got a new moon coming in too, and I'll come back and do one on that. Bye.